In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a mid-side equalizer using Patcher, Stereo Shaper, and a pair of parametric EQ2s. Mid-side EQ is about processing center or mono and stereo parts of a mix separately. Listen how this setting boosts the high frequencies in the stereo parts, the clap in particular. Great, let's delete this and start from scratch. So our ingredients include one patcher, two parametric EQ2s, and a stereo shaper that I'll drop in the audio path here and save some routing. Let's check the signal mix passing through patcher. Good. Now we need to split the audio into the mid and side components. Fortunately, Stereo Shaper has a preset that does just that. It's under Presets, Mixing, Mid, A-Side Splitter. The A means adapted, in that it's designed to create a stereo mix when you recombine the mid and the side signals together later. That's explained in the manual in detail. Now, the main output from Stereo Shaper will be the mid, mono, or center pan components of the signal. The side or stereo parts of the mix is now present on the in-out difference output too. I'll just activate that from the patcher editor. Right-click, outputs, audio, send to, matching the setting here. Great, now we have a mid and a side EQ. Let's name them to save confusion. Let's hear what happens if I disable the side or stereo feed. Cool, that seems as expected. However, if you disable the mid or mono feed, you don't hear stereo. Well, you do, but it's not in stereo. That's because the side only becomes stereo when it's mixed back in with the mid signal. Why this is so is explained in the Stereo Shaper manual, and I encourage you to exercise that F1 finger. Let's open the EQs, Alt plus click to open both at once, and use the side EQ to boost the high frequencies in the stereo part of the mix. And as you can hear, we're back to where we started at the beginning of the tutorial. Compare that to boosting the same frequencies in the mid or mono parts. As you'd expect, a brighter mid or center versus a brighter side or stereo. Mid-side EQ is often useful as a mastering effect, but the internet is awash with articles on things you can do with mid-side EQ, so I'll leave you to explore on your own there. If you stick around, I'll explain why the mid EQ display analysis doesn't show on the bottom EQ too. Let's load another stereo shaper just before the mid EQ and cut the right channel. The mid signal contains an identical waveform but phase inverted in the left and right channels. Since the EQ2's analysis display adds the left and right signals, they perfectly phase cancel and the display appears blank. But that's only a visual thing and perhaps something we can address with a future update. Now we're done, I can save the preset and use it in future projects. For the very lazy, I will put the link in the description with a download. but I encourage you to build your own. It's all good practice. Don't forget, you can also copy patches within your project by dragging the Save preset as menu option. Until next time, enjoy your mid-side EQing.